What a set.
So who we got next?
That was phenomenal.
That's going to be a tough match to follow.
All right, so we got Beard Sr. and Prince Kex.
Now, I've seen a bit of Beard Sr., never seen Prince play.
I played him last time, actually, and he 2-0'd me.
Who, Prince?
Prince Kex, yeah. He's a Fox main.
Ooh. Always fun.
Really good, technically. He's got some good moves. Like I said, he 2-0'd me. Yeah. I'm excited to see this, man. I think Fox definitely beats Game & Watch on paper.
I don't know. I'm biased to Game & Watch. I'm playing with PM.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm a bit biased, though. He's pretty fun in this, too.
Well, I do assure you he's pretty garbage. I mean, he's fun. He's a fun character, but he...
I can pull out some moves.
Definitely would lose the Fox matchup. But Beard Sr., a super good player. Cool. Yeah.
He was number two right here.
Oh, is that the seeding right there?
Yeah.
Nice.
It's Dr. Napkins, Beard Sr., Prez, Stewards, and I.
There we go.
As our leaderboard.
Fox!
Kex. I believe so. Fox versus Game & Watch.
Prince Kex. Yeah, put a little tilde in the middle. There we go. Just like that. Alright, we are stage striking. I think both players want Battlefield.
Probably.
I think that's how this goes. Beard Sr. took me to FD before, so maybe that's just a personal preference. That would probably be his best bet against Fox. But Fox would like pretty much anything with platforms. Battlefield's such a good stage for him.
We're going to Final Destination.
Alright. Here we go. Fist bump, and we are in Prince Kex versus Beard Sr.
Starting right off the bat. Good spam going in. Right with the jab combo.
We got Duel of Fates playing in the background. It is on right now.
Kex seems to like run out of distance using all his distance options and bringing him in real close.
Uh-huh.
Jab combo.
Definitely just baits out that down air. Beard Sr. loves landing with that. You gotta be careful.
Down air always does feel pretty nice to hit. Pretty good lead for Prince Kex right now. Beard Sr. could recover. He seems to be trying pretty hard right now. He's just gotta get past that spacing issue he's having.
Wow, great power shield from Kex. I thought that was gonna catch him out.
Sr. returning the favor with the jab combo.
And definitely.
And dab.
So Kex takes an early command right here. Stockley is only 59%. He could get some serious extra credit.
Trying for the hammer. Could get a 9.
Here comes the Fox. Fox Vortex right here. We can get this going. We can see big damage real quick.
So Fox is pretty high up, but he's got a stock lead. He's just trying to get Beard Sr. a good edge guard right now so he can recover.
Yep. Beard Sr. is throwing out smash attacks. I'm not sure if he's trying to read an aggressive approach or if he's just throwing out desperate options here, but definitely not working out for him either way.
Some of the smashes have some long to get Foxy, so maybe.
Wow, that Firefox actually almost took the stock.
Ooh, got the up smash there. So it's stock-wise even, but huge lead for Kex's side.
Yeah, 96%.
Got him in the grab.
Huge for Game & Watch. One solid hit from Fox, and that's gonna be it. Up air, gets the air dodge read, but just kind of misspaces it.
Right there, he's going for
flash on the stage. Can't land an up air, but he's pressuring him so hard right now.
This might be almost there.
Watch, is so light. He's alive
he's
at 145
so
still.
145. Ooh, he just got a 1. Took some damage there. 16 to 159 now.
Kex can honestly just kind of sit back and let Beard Sr. approach. Game & Watch does not have approach options, you know?
Not really, no.
He can really let Beard Sr. come to him. Jab to up smash. That was actually confirmed. That's a Larry Lur combo right there. And Kex takes it 1-0 so far. And that was pretty commanding, I'd say. I think he abused the matchup.
Used to his full advantage.
Because I mean,
very aggressive at the beginning.
Beard Sr. was having so much trouble landing. And that's just what Fox does. He keeps you in the air. He juggles. And then he forces those air dodges and punishes. And Kex was doing that so well to Beard Sr.'s Game & Watch.
He started to take his time nearly in there.
Yeah.
After an aggressive start.
Yeah, yeah.
Didn't want to get too cocky, maybe.
Yeah, definitely. It worked out, you know. It slowed it down and really took the game by storm. We're going right back to FD. I think that's the right call for Beard Sr. You can't bring him to Battlefield or anything. Just because of that.
Salty rematch is going. Play another aggressive play. Beard Sr. is trying to stay in the air to avoid those lasers.
Kex with the offstage. Bare footstool, almost. But Beard Sr. saw it coming, took care of it.
Tried for the key again, just missed, got another grab.
But now we know the fair footstool is on the table, and that's always
that's
terrifying.
A dangerous game right there.
This man definitely pays attention to his Larry Low Tech.
Bucket.
Oh,
I see that pulled out last game.
That's right. With the nine hammer.
Does he have the magic touch of the nine?
The RNG hype.
Nine's wonky in this game. I'm not a big fan of it, honestly. At least in the PM9 where you can read it. So now we're looking in Beard Sr.'s favor. Percent-wise even, but stock lead because of not the jabs. Not trying to grab a bucket anymore.
But yeah, I remember Prince Kex pretty much two-stock last game. I mean,
it's true.
Not to say that it was that one-sided, but he barely took any percentage on his second stock. This is not out of the question for him to bring this back. Here we go.
He's bringing back.
Yeah, these nice strings. Bucket more lasers. I'm looking forward to see how Beard Sr. is going to utilize that bucket once it's full.
Bucket's always a very dangerous thing, but sometimes pretty hard to hit off. Fast. Just missed the bucket. Missed the smash. Trying to go for an up air.
Go up smash, nope.
Just missed the up smash into a jab combo.
Yeah, he didn't get the untackable spinning animation. A little too aggressive there. Toot-toot.
A little too aggressive.
Is that a full bucket?
Maybe it is. I don't know, a bucket would finish this off nicely here. Tie him up.
Oh, for sure.
Not a full button.
That almost ended the game right there. Beard Sr. is looking so much better.
He's playing a lot better this time. He bred the aggressiveness. Try to keep him at his pace now.
Yeah, I'm thinking that nine hammer might have just shifted the momentum, to be honest. Because ever since then, we've been playing at Beard Sr.'s pace.
Nine is always the worst thing to get hit by. It just doesn't quite feel right once you get killed by it.
Yeah.
Especially on low percent.
And there we go.
Tied it up with an up smash.
Game & Watch up smash. So strong.
I feel like the up smashes are just a no-joke today.
Well, we saw Mario in a Game & Watch back-to-back, so that's to be expected. Alright, so Game 3 coming out right here.
Are they going to go Battlefield somewhere else, or are they keeping Final Fantasy?
I would imagine the ban would be Battlefield. So we might see, like, Smashville.
Smashville is always
fun. Probably not Town against the Game & Watch. I doubt we're going back to FD. He left Battlefield open. Interesting. He must have banned Lila. But we are going into Game 3 here on Battlefield.
Haven't seen anyone in Lila. Aggressive start again from Pex. Senior seems to be reading a lot better, got into the jab combo. Trying to edge guard the neutral lead. Another jab combo.
Pex being zoned out right now.
Senior got to throw out a one that's not great, but seems to got the hang of Pex's approach. Trying to keep him on his own pace.
Ooh.
Just missed that nine.
That would have been crushing.
I gotta go.
Alright. Good luck, Zixilius. Alright, Riot Kex is trying out a Pressure Beard Senior on these platforms. Toot Toot does not kill. We are on Battlefield. That high ceiling might have kept Kex alive right there. But now Game & Watch is the one in disadvantage. And then they're down onto the super armor to up smash. Continue taking the first stock. Can Kex bring this back? It's not out of the question. He's at 70%. Beard Senior is going to try to get as much extra credit as humanly possible here. And the bucket's full. This is terrifying. He grabs
one grab in his good game, man. One grab in his good game.
One grab.
This is scary. This is looking really, really, really scary for Kex. By the way, it's Zenai and Mike here. This is, oh my god, this is scary, man. I mean, I saw game one, I mean, game two, I saw Kex firing up his lasers. I figured, I saw the bucket, he wasn't gonna shoot again.
Yeah, and here it is. And the bucket.
Bacon combos into bacon.
There we go.
Remember that, man.
But the bucket's off the table, remember that.
Oh, yep.
Ooh, that was dangerous. Kex needs to take the stock off.
This Fox, man. You know, no tutu, not no air dodging, that's really good. That's really good. Kex staying alive in that. No tutu once again. Back air should not kill. Back air's pretty weak, unless it catches you.
That's right, yeah.
Oh my god.
Firefox. Dangerous.
Kex is scared, man. Lead up E. Okay.
That was a bit
It's not like he could do anything off.
Up? Tilt?
Alright.
All right. 136 Rage Fox. I get it.
He's scared. I'd be scared as crap too, man.
And there it is. Rolling a bit too much in the end there, but a fantastic set. Prince Kex taking the game off of our number two senior, Beard Senior. But Beard Senior does bring it all the way back.
Let's go, Stu!
This is a run back.
Let's see.
From two Riptides ago?
Oh, yes.
All right, see?
We have Damien and Stu.
Look familiar, too familiar. I mean, obviously, familiar faces. I mean.